The Ashanti region alone recorded 3.9% HIV prevalence rate last year, making it the second highest region in Ghana after Eastern. A major contributory factor to the spread of HIV in the Ashanti region is commercial sex. Here's a commercial sex worker who told her client she could do anything with any man for money, irrespective of the consequences.
I am 20 years and I come from Wa. I came to Kumasi to find some work. I started as an apprentice, hairdresser, but I have no choice because I have to survive. I have never gone to the hospital to test, but I do not care what happens. I need the money.
After contracting the disease, where do patients turn to? The pastor, herbalist, or the traditional priest? According to statistics available, more than 23,000 people died of AIDS last year alone in Ghana. Many of the dead could have had their lives prolonged if they were actively taking their antiretroviral drugs.
HIV do one so rather than me so one sound so me team inka.
The Yakion is a CID. You were Nipa Bear 8.
Sir Doctor, to me catch our same Fiemi and Sir Anabuya, met me the infusion from my account.
Over the years, the National AIDS Control Program has increasingly become aware of such claims. These healers have told victims different and funny stories about how the disease is contracted. Patients in most cases tend to believe these healers. Subsequently, these patients invariably end up rejecting their ARVs. Ashanti Regional AIDS Coordinator Dr. Ejakupoku is worried about the practices of these healers.
It's unfortunate that some people are trespassing to prescribe drugs that are not needed, to recommend treatment that are not supported by any evidence. Sometimes they go as far as telling people, telling them not to come for drugs from the hospital. And that we think is very dangerous.
These religious leaders are traversing into medical practice alongside the traditional responsibility of providing guidance to salvation. Are their victims the gullible or there are substance to claim of cure?
Last 2 weeks, I'm bad.
I was diagnosed recently of HIV/AIDS, so a friend directed me to Pastor Obinim. Since I came, he has given me directions which I am following. I was not sexually promiscuous and I do not know how I got the disease. But I will go and test again and I know I will be negative in Jesus' name.
Ajua could not tell us which hospital she will be visiting after she is done with Pastor Obinim's directions. The practice of these healers in the Ashanti region is common and herbalists are not left out. We ask, has their work been proven in any recognized scientific facility like the Noguchi Memorial Institute? General Overseer of the God's Way International Church, Bishop Daniel Obinim, says he has cured several AIDS patients. A patient does not go through healing without suffering some agony, which in itself can cause other physical problems. Margaret says she has been cured by Pastor Obinim. Has she indeed been cured?
Mommy,
the pastor has prayed for me, and I'm healed now. I don't have any HIV/AIDS in my body now. Pastor Obi Nim gave me direction, which I followed, and that has helped me to get healed. After the prayers and direction, I went to the hospital to test again, but the nurses told me I was negative.
Is there proof signifying she has been cured? She was not able to tell us the hospital which conducted the test for her, where she tested negative. Even though Pastor Binim says he can cure the AIDS, a traditional priest in the Ashanti Bekwai, Odakonfo, throws up a challenge to anyone who claims to have completely healed AIDS patients. He's underlying the fact that it is important to have a scientific proof. A United Kingdom trained herbalist, Amanko Abdallah, says he had his herbal HIV and AIDS drugs researched by Europeans.
European countries now registered £30,000 and group back up. Easy, the whole Africa,
but we ask why the medicine has not been recommended by the supposed Europeans for the treatment of AIDS. He did not have an answer as to which laboratory even conducted a test in the UK. Amankwa says he does not want his medicine to interfere with the ARVs, so he asked the patients to concentrate on his prepared herbs. Manager of the National AIDS Control Program, Dr. Ni Akweado, says once the virus is detected in a body, it can never be removed completely.
Once you have HIV in your body, the body produces antibodies. And it's this that we test. The antibodies will never vanish from your system. And so if you test antibody positive and you come back tomorrow to come and tell me that the lab has now confirmed that you are antibody negative, it's difficult to accept scientifically. Basically because once you have antibodies for life. And you cannot clean the antibodies in your body.
Regional AIDS coordinator Dr. Ejakunpoku says it is about time people stop putting all their trust in pastors and herbalists to heal them. He pleads with the healers to put a stop to their not scientifically proven healings. He further asks from healers to stop preventing AIDS patients from taking their ARVs.
HIV requires a component, a complete system of treatment. It does not rest only with administration of drugs. We need care and support, and this can be provided by people on the other side who are not practicing orthodox medicine. We do expect that they can cope with the counseling and other spiritual aspect as people may demand, whilst we continue with our drugs and things that are provided at the hospital.
In the next episode, we will continue with our investigations into practices of these religious leaders and healers. Instead of offering psychological help to complement the work of the National AIDS Control Program, we will visit the Central Region. So join Adam Srim next week as he brings you exclusively a traditional priest who admits an HIV and AIDS patient died in the course of treatment at his base.